Okay, when we want spin, when we want party talking points, we know who to go to. We bring on the backbench MPs and all that sort of stuff. But when we want it how it really is, we go to David Akin. You better believe it. So now I'm joined by David Akin in studio. And David, I got to ask you, I hear that we're learning about some stuff that on its own might seem rosy and peachy in particular writings, but when you put it together, it presents a bit of an annoying picture. Tell me about this.
Okay, here's what happened. Our MPs are on a break week. They're not in Ottawa. They're not in the House of Commons. They're on a break week. They're back in their ridings. What do MPs do when they're back in their ridings? They hand out checks, and they've been handing them out like crazy. And of course, this week we saw Minister Flaherty stand up and say, woe is us. We're in a tougher financial position. Deficit's going to happen for 5 years. But so far this week, we have seen more than 70 check presentations across the country for a grand total of $54 million. And what are this kind of stuff that people are handing out? Cowichan, B.C., yesterday, the Minister of State for Western Economic Diversification, Lynn Yelich, she shows up. Here's a check for $98,000 so that the fitness gym in Cowichan can buy some new fitness equipment. That's one thing that it was, I guess, appropriate federal taxpayers spend money on. Good news about that is if you sign up for the gym, you also qualify for the federal fitness tax credit.
So that's federal money. It comes from what tranche of finance does that come from?
Most of these things, I mentioned about 70 things, most of them come from regional economic development agencies. And there's one for every region of the country. There's a COA in the Maritimes, the Western Economic Diversification for Manitoba West, one for the North, one for Southern Ontario. These regional economic development agencies basically get $1 billion a year combined, and their job is to find projects that help with economic development in various ridings. We saw the federal government, part of their stimulus program was something called the Recreational Infrastructure Fund. So this was an additional pile of $2 billion given to these regional development agencies, and they would find places to give recreational infrastructure.
So we've got up on the screen now just a sign showing various things. We got gluten-free bakery for $1 million.
There's your regional development fund.
Absolutely. That's quite wonderful. You talked about economic benefits for the community. That seems like a rather discretionary term to me.
Yeah, and it is the local communities that apply to these funds. So local places, say, in the gluten-free bakery, for example, that's in Edmonton. So the bakery said to the government, oh, you can give me some money? And filled out the form, and they got the money. Look at the top two, snowmobile grooming machines.
Twice.
Yeah, those are just two this week. But this is one that I find kind of interesting, and I want to talk about this, for instance. So we all love snowmobiling. Snowmobiling is great. Snowmobiling brings a lot of economic activity to rural areas of the country, northwestern Ontario, Quebec, you name it. We love snowmobiling. In the last parliament, the federal government handed out about 30 checks to snowmobile clubs, all of which were in the province of Quebec, totaling $6 million. New Brunswick, they gave New Brunswick $300,000 to fix up some trails. Newfoundland got $150,000 to run a snowmobile race. But clubs in Quebec were getting brand new snowmobile grooming machines. These cost like $100,000 or more. And the federal government helped underwrite them. Nowhere else in the country did anybody get any snowmobile money. So we either sit back and say, well, that's not fair. All snowmobile clubs in the country ought to get some federal funding because it's an important thing we do, snowmobiles. Or better yet, we take the cue from Minister Flaherty saying, we're broke. We got to control our spending and say, trail fees pay for snowmobile grooming machines. It's a user pay activity. It's not an Ottawa pay activity.
David, let's cut to the chase here. I mean, this doesn't seem to me like just randomly helping communities. There seems to be some politicization at the root of all these decisions.
I think that you can make the case there is. The government, of course, say, no, there's not. Remember I said it is the local communities that make the application. And in some cases, some of this funding is contingent on provincial funding. So in Ontario, for example, the Liberals will want to show off their ridings and then they don't match to Conservatives. In some cases, it's the case. I'm going to give you an example here. There's something called the New Horizons Seniors Fund. This is run by Diane Finley, the Human Resources Minister.
And you can never criticize seniors funding.
I'm going to criticize seniors funds. This is $25 million a year. And seniors groups across the country can, again, apply for access. They get grants of about $25,000 per pop out of this fund.
What are they going to do with this money?
At one point, we tracked 50 consecutive announcements out of this fund. You know, here's a check for you, here's a check for you. 49 of the 50 went to Conservative ridings. And here's what they spent it on. Alice Wong, who is the MP for Richmond, British Columbia, she had a $7,000 check so she could have an intergenerational movie night in Richmond. $7,000 so seniors and kids could watch a movie together.
David, sorry, we're out of time.
All right, I could go on and on.